Listen, I am looking into search engines for a project. I keep coming across ElasticSearch, Solr, Sphinx, and Apache Lucene. How do they compare?
That's a great area to explore. At their core, they are all search engine frameworks designed to enable powerful search capabilities on large volumes of data. But they do have their differences.
Could you start by explaining the main differences?
Sure. Apache Lucene is actually the foundation for both ElasticSearch and Solr. It's a high-performance, full-featured text search engine library written in Java. ElasticSearch is built on top of Lucene and provides a distributed, multi-tenant capable full-text search engine with an HTTP web interface and schema-free JSON documents. Solr is also built on Lucene and is highly reliable, scalable, and fault-tolerant, providing distributed indexing, replication, and load-balance querying with a centralized configuration.
Any ideas?
Sphinx is a bit different. It's a standalone search engine meant to provide fast, relevant search capabilities with SQL querying.
So, Lucene is like the engine under the hood for ElasticSearch and Solr?
Exactly. Lucene is essentially a library that provides the indexing and search technology. ElasticSearch and Solr offer more features on top, like RESTful APIs, distributed nature, and a more extensive set of tools and plugins.
How would I choose one over the other?
ElasticSearch is generally preferred for its ease of use, scalability, and robust ecosystem, particularly when it comes to real-time search and analytics. It's part of the Elastic Stack, which provides a suite of tools for data ingestion, enrichment, storage, analysis, and visualization. Solr, on the other hand, might be chosen for complex search tasks, especially when you need strong support for faceted search and filtering. It integrates well with the Hadoop ecosystem and offers great performance for traditional search applications. Sphinx is often selected for applications that are SQL-centric and might already be heavily reliant on MySQL, as it can directly integrate with MySQL databases.
And if I wanted to do a simple full-text search, how would that look in each?
In Lucene, you would write something like this. This snippet creates an index searcher, parses a query for the term search text, and retrieves the top 10 results.
What about an ElasticSearch?
ElasticSearch makes it quite simple. This is a JSON RESTful API call that searches MyIndex for the content that matches search text.
And for Solr?
Solr's example would be a bit similar to ElasticSearch because it's also via an HTTP API. This HTTP GET request queries my collection for content that contains search text.
And Sphinx?
Sphinx is unique because it integrates with SQL. Here's how you would search in Sphinx using SphinxQL, which mimics SQL. You query it as if it were a database, selecting from MyIndex where the text matches search text.
That's pretty clear. What about performance and scaling?
ElasticSearch is designed to be scalable and can handle large amounts of data and heavy write loads. It can be easily scaled out by adding more nodes to the cluster. Solr also scales well, especially with features like Solr Cloud, which adds distributed indexing and search capabilities. But it can be a bit more complex to set up and manage compared to ElasticSearch. Sphinx is lightweight and extremely fast, particularly for indexing and search operations, but it might not be as easy to scale out as ElasticSearch. Lucene itself is just a library, so scaling it would involve a lot of manual work to distribute and manage indexes across multiple servers.
How about ease of setup and management?
ElasticSearch is generally considered to have a smoother learning curve, with a lot of community and vendor support. Kibana, part of the Elastic stack, provides a powerful interface for managing and visualizing data in ElasticSearch. Solr has a more traditional enterprise focus, and while it's very powerful, it can take more time to learn and master. However, it has an admin UI which can be quite helpful. Sphinx offers simplicity and is easy to set up for small to medium-sized projects, especially if you are already working within a SQL environment.
What if I need to process natural language or work with different languages?
Lucene has extensive analysis capabilities that can be extended through ElasticSearch and Solr, both of which offer strong support for multilingual content and natural language processing. ElasticSearch and Solr have built-in analyzers for many languages, and they both support custom analyzers. You can also use plugins like ElasticSearch's ingest attachment plugin to extract text from various formats, which is useful for natural language processing tasks. Sphinx has support for morphology and can work with different character sets, but it might not be as feature-rich in terms of language processing as ElasticSearch or Solr.
This has been really informative. Thanks.
My pleasure.